You are not going to believe, ladies and gentlemen, the manner in which rape-accused Bishop Franco Mulakkal was welcomed back by his church in Jalandhar in Punjab yesterday. He's been in custody, as you probably know, for 25 days in Kerala on charges of raping a nun over 2 years. Very, very grievous allegations. He's already been under attack for enjoying the protection of the state, the police, and of course the church itself. Now, what would you say to a rape-accused priest receiving a hero's welcome with every kind of adornment and adulation? What kind of message does it really send out? But before you think about that, watch what that welcome was really like.
Flower petals showered, bouquets, garlands, hugs and handshakes, banners of love. This is the hero's welcome that rape-accused priest Bishop Franco Mulakkal received on his return to his church in Jalandhar yesterday. After spending 25 days in custody in Kerala, Bishop Franco enjoyed this rousing swagat on his arrival by members of Catholic community, who rounded off his adulation by even organizing a special prayer. Fighting allegations of rape, the bishop now resumes duties here at his church. These images of adulation appear to completely drown out the very serious allegation of rape against the bishop by a nun who was in his church, and could be seen as a show of strength against the nuns who have protested for weeks demanding justice against the bishop. But a smiling Bishop Mulakkal, lapping up the love he received on arrival, continues to hold out against the allegations.
I have cooperated with the police and I have answered all the questions. More than this, there is nothing that I can do. Now, whatever be the further proceedings, I have to cooperate.
With the hero's welcome also seemingly deaf to the Me Too uprising in the country, in which hundreds of women have found strength to call out predators, the bishop chose to play safe on the topic.
I have nothing to say at the moment on these things.
While innocent until proven guilty and due process are solid principles to live by, these images are particularly stinging because they come after a non-stop show of power and strength by the bishop, including delays in his arrest, being defended by several church entities, and apparent special treatment by the police.
The jail warden and other staff were very respectful, and I am proud of Kerala police.
This disturbing show of love to a rape-accused priest also comes after the bishop has embarked on a campaign to malign and insult the nun who accuses him of rape.
The entire this Catholic fraternity is saddened seeing his way of doing as he came to Jalandhar. He is coming back from jail, not of the course of other people, but him because of his mistake.
The question that must now be asked is, has Bishop Mulakkal's hero-style welcome insulted just the nun who accuses him of rape? Or has it insulted every rape survivor in the country? With Manjeet Sehgal in Jalandhar, Bureau Report, India Today.
Joining me live now, John Dayal, Secretary General of the All India Christian Council, commentator. Also with us is Manjeet Sehgal, my colleague from Jalandhar. In a moment, we'll be also joined by Madhu Kishwar, founder of Manushi and professor at the Indian Council for Social Science Research. Manjeet, coming to you first. You were there in Jalandhar when this enormous, very meticulous hero's welcome was laid out. This was a red carpet welcome with every kind of respect, every kind of, adornment for the rape-accused Bishop Franco Mulakkal. You know, for us looking at it on the outside, it looks very, very jarring, very, very odd. We have the Me Too, movement going on. But apart from that, this is a man who faces grievous charges of rape, Manjeet.
has accorded a rousing welcome by his supporters. A sizable chunk of the supporters also included females and nuns also. We also spoke to a nun who said that the allegations leveled against Franco Mulakkal were baseless and he was innocent. Besides this, banners were being raised in his support. Slogans were also shouted in his support. And a special prayer was also organized for him in Jalandhar. We also spoke to Franco Mulakkal. He is saying that the allegations leveled against him were false. And now, after appearing before the Kerala police, he has got a chance to prove his innocence in the court.
It's amazing. John Dayal, in this country, we do believe in innocent until proven guilty. But surely a welcome for Bishop Franco Mulakkal of this kind cannot be endorsed because of the kind of message it sends out. He's a rape-accused bishop. He may not be pronounced guilty just yet, but what kind of message does this send out?
I think these are terrible messages that are being sent out, both in Kerala, where the Supreme Court is being insulted by a section of the people who claim they are very devout, and I suppose in Jalandhar, where people seem to be presuming that the court has given its verdict. I mean, such a welcome would be quite in order if he were exonerated. So I quite agree with you that there is an element of the jarring in these two things, the violation of the Supreme Court's orders and this presumption that he has been exonerated.
It's okay to conflate the two issues. I just want to make an important clarification here that on India Today, we treat both those stories separately. We don't join those two stories. If you watched Five Live yesterday, you will see what on this show we said about the violence that was taking place in Sabarimala and the disrespect that's being shown to the Supreme Court over there and the people who are involved there. So conflating the two issues is basically mitigating the issue on this particular case. I want you to focus on this particular case right now because you appear to be taking it lightly on the church here in that case.
No, my dear friend, I'm not here to obey your orders. I'm here to give you my opinion on what you're presenting.
I am
saying that this is a very jarring response from the people because he has not yet been exonerated. He continues to be an accused till he's exonerated or found guilty. Till then, that is the situation. I just wanted to correct you. He has not resumed duties.
No, that's fine. That's a small technical clarification. I'm talking about the welcome that this man has received.
It's a major clarification,
sir,
because it has caught you.
The story here is not that he's resumed office. The story here is not that he's resumed office. The headline here is the welcome that he's got back. You may have a clarification on whether he's resumed office or not, but that's a technical clarification. The fact here is the kind of welcome he's received. Madhu Kishwar, welcome. Thank you for being with us. Madhu, what kind of message do you think this has sent out? You know, flowers, garlands, these enormous crowds. There was apparently a special ceremony for this priest as well. Sure, innocent until proven guilty is a principle that, you know, should stand tall. But what kind of messaging goes out from this, ma'am?
This is truly, truly appalling, because imagine if Akbar, MG Akbar, as he landed in Delhi, if BJP cadre had organized a welcome reception for him and carried him with the dhol and nagaras as though in a victory procession, all hell would have broken loose.
Yeah.
And people, even though charges against Akbar are not of rape, they are of a different order. And in this case, when the horrible stories that nuns have told about this man's
are you condoning?
The least you do
Madhu,
is to take it quietly. This shows brazenness.
John Dayal, let us finish.
Sorry? I'm what? Ishwar is not the issue today. I'm comparing him with Akbar's charges. Now the whole country rose to demand his resignation, and BJP had to do so. Okay. Secondly, I'm saying compare it with Akbar in the sense that had BJP cadre received Akbar at the airport as he landed in India with this kind of victory procession, you would have yourself, John Dayal, found yourself outraging and emoting profusely against it.
This is
now the point is the church ought to take responsibility for at least keeping this man low key. So what if he's on bail? He doesn't become a rock star. He doesn't become a big celebrity.
He's been treated like a rock star.
By your
you know, since
own
you
nuns,
use that word, Madhu Kishwar,
the same order.
John Dayal, he's been treated like a rock star. That's precisely what has happened. The church is complicit in this man being treated not just as a protected individual, but now as a rock star. I mean, you can't cut away the church and say this was the spontaneous reaction of people from the parish or the people from that church. This was obviously something that was organized, and he's been treated, like Madhu Kishwar says, like a rock star, John Dayal.
You have an option to believe what you construct,
and what is more,
or do you have an option to listen to what I'm saying?
Women and of the same order, his own congregation, who are accusing him. It's not outsiders.
Yes, let John Dayal answer.
There's some outsiders planted to accuse him, so you can even have a saving grace that this is some kind of a conspiracy.
Let John Dayal answer
now,
that.
Now, when your
it's
own
a fair
people,
question.
Women who
this
work
is internal.
Under
this
you,
is from within the church. The allegation is from a nun.
No, no, I cannot interrupt Madhu after she has finished. Give me a signal because I can't see both of you.
John Dayal,
and I
the floor is yours. Answer,
seconds.
Then I'll bring Madhu Kishwar back in. John Dayal, go ahead. Answer that.
Okay, I began by saying I myself find it jarring because his followers there seem to have presumed that the bail is an exoneration. The bail is pending a trial, and maybe they should have waited till he was exonerated.
Maybe.
And then they could have welcomed him precisely. So do hold on for a minute. What I'm trying to say is, when you use loosely words like he has resumed duties, when you say the church has organized it, when you so loudly proclaim that there's a conspiracy to make him a rock star, then, my dear friend,
why was there
totally
a ceremony in the church for him, sir? Why was there a ceremony in the church for him? Please tell me that then. You're saying the church had nothing to do with this. I can confirm to you that our reporters tell us there was a ceremony in the church for him.
Your reporter is not an expert in Catholic rituals. Churches are for prayers. They're for prayers for convicts.
Where Bishop Mulakkal was there?
There was
where
a prayer.
Bishop Mulakkal was there. Okay.
Why should he?
No.
Bishop Mulakkal is
a
Catholic.
And calling it another.
He has a right to be.
You're being very lenient.
He
That's
has
okay,
a
John.
Right to be.
John, it's okay.
You are being.
It's okay to see that you want to be lenient on the
being,
church. In this case, that's fine.
No. I am a Catholic.
That's fine. You're
I'm a Catholic.
Jarring, no. You're being very lenient with them, sir. You're being very lenient with the church.
I am not.
This is a rape accused bishop.
He is not a convict.
Yes.
You admit yourself, is it not?
So he deserves bouquets and garlands.
Amit Shah was in jail. Amit Shah was given a clean chit. Now everybody presents
so him. So you're admitting that it's wrong.
You're saying,
admitting that it's horrible and wrong. Then.
No, I began by saying that I find it extremely jarring.
Okay.
You know what it means?
Hello.
Jarring is the same thing that you're saying.
You're weighing your words very carefully, John Dayal, as far as the church is concerned. But Madhu Kishwar, I want to ask you, isn't this an insult not just to the nun who has leveled the allegations against Bishop Mulakkal, but also to rape survivors in general, ma'am? Who can ignore the atmosphere in the country right now? Me Too is one part of it. But in general, violence against women, isn't this an insult to all rape survivors?
No, That's one. It's an insult to rape survivors. It is also an insult to the entire judicial machinery. You come out on bail and you treat the man accused of heinous crimes. It's really like custodial rape, you know. It's not just any ordinary rape.
What is this?
As you well know, in the rape law, custodial rape is treated... One second. Custodial rape is treated with greater severity. Thirdly, if this is the following this bishop commands, then it's a telling commentary on the fact that the church is converting lumpen elements. They're not converting respectable citizens. They are winning over, bringing into the fold lumpen elements.
You are building,
because only lumpen elements would treat a rape accused
you're building
as a rock star.
On a premise, which is wrong, which is a premise, which is wrong. The premise is that this is organized. I am saying the church
How can the church have nothing to do with this? How can you say that the church has nothing to do with this?
We've got to
subvert the Supreme Court. Listen.
You're saying the church has nothing to do with this. Look at the banners, sir. Look at the banners.
You think Modi...
Look at India Today's TV screen, sir. There are huge banners on the church saying hearty welcome to our beloved Bishop Mulakkal. Hearty welcome to Bishop Mulakkal.
I'm not saying it.
This is the church. These are banners on the church. How can you say the church is not complicit?
Are you telling me that Modi is conspiring to subvert the Supreme Court?
I am simply asking you about why the church... Why is the church laying out the red carpet for this man? Could they not have brought him back in a normal, dignified manner without so much pomp and show and adulation and crowds? That's a simple question I'm asking you, sir.
I only get the tone of your voice. I can't see you because I'm in this room where I don't have a screen.
Yes.
What I want to tell you is, going strictly by the tone of your voice, you're building a presumption, an edifice, on a basic falsehood. You're saying it's a conspiracy by the church to give a hero's welcome and to malign nurses. I'm saying all this is crap.
Okay.
It is not a conspiracy.
Let me tell you the timeline in that case, John Dayal. Just to remind you, I know you know the timeline very well. Madhu Kishwar, you can also just join in.
I just want
to remind people of the timeline here. This man has enjoyed the protection of the church. He's enjoyed police lenience. He's enjoyed the shield afforded by the state. He did not come when he was summoned for the first time. And you're saying that the church is not complicit. There is a history of this man being protected, sir.
I am telling you the church is not complicit.
Okay.
I'm telling you,
Madhu Kishwar, is the church directly complicit for what's happening? Or is the church not? I would like to repeat once again that those flowers, the ceremony and the banner was on the church.
We saw the visuals on the TV screen.
Then Modi is complicit in sabotaging the Supreme Court.
Exactly.
I'm asking you about the church.
Church should have been out of bounds, John.
I am asking you about Modi.
Church doors should have been shut to him. You cannot...
Let Madhu Kishwar answer. I'll come back to you.
And he's brought to
Madhu,
the church.
What do you know?
He didn't go to his house.
Madhu, you are. I would say.
Had he gone to his house?
Are you complicit by not putting pressure on your friend Mr. Modi in the case of Sabarimala? Are you complicit in subverting the Supreme Court? No.
So doesn't excuse the other, sir. The
everything,
John
everything Dayal, is Modi,
one doesn't
Modi,
excuse
Modi.
The other.
Stop your Modi
you
obsession.
Precisely.
You obsessed
precisely.
About Modi
I
for
began by
18
saying,
long years.
I began,
now shut up about
you
Modi.
You are obsessed with the church.
And look
Madhu,
at
Madhu, you're obsessed with the church.
Clean up
Madhu,
your own house.
You're obsessed with the church.
You know, John Dayal.
You clean your house.
John Dayal, the church has embarrassed you here.
From chasing
within
women.
The
you
church,
listen,
I have
you
countless examples
women.
I can you cite to that have even come to my
Kerala.
Machine.
I want
shame.
To say something.
Shame
I want to say something.
Women.
No, John.
I'm attacking
John,
women.
John, it sounds like the church has embarrassed you
shame.
Today because
I'm
you're a reasonable
women.
Man.
I'm sitting here and
you're a reasonable man. The church
women.
Has embarrassed you today. And you're saying that these images are jarring, but the church is not complicit.
I am saying
bouquets being given by priests, banner on the church. But church is not complicit in making Bishop rockstar Mulakkal.
Because my dear friend, because Akbar is complicit, doesn't mean you are complicit or I. We are all three journalists. Please tell me.
Can a church?
Church is not complicit.
You know, I want to play that image once again.
Don't laugh, because then I would accuse you of me too.
No, please accuse me of whatever you want, John Dayal. I am asking you a very reasonable question. I am not yelling at you.
Funny.
I respect you. Let's show that image.
I'm not yelling at you.
Look at the size of the banner.
I'm in a room. Facing a camera, I began by saying,
Respected Sir John Dayal, just listen to my question. Madhu Kishwar can also listen. You've got an image on our screen of the entire church welcoming him with a banner that is hiding the entire front of the church. Who's put that banner there if not the church, sir? Who's put the banner there if not the church? A banner
you chap,
saying,
listen
to
me.
Welcome to our church, brother Francis Mulakkal.
The least
please understand.
You owed yourself,
please
John
understand.
Dayal.
Church
is
has
to
many
ensure
leadings.
That he went
the church
quietly.
Is not complicit. Are you saying the building?
And
Madhu Kishwar, you are an educated person at least. You listen to me. Church is a body of Christ. The building is also a church. So when you say church is complicit, I tell you the church is not complicit.
Every single thing.
Followers.
Madhu Kishwar. I want, since
Why
John Dayal is refusing to climb down from his position about the church being complicit,
I
just want to say,
down
you know, everyone has forgotten.
John Dayal, in the impact of these
very disturbing pictures of the rape accused bishop being feted and garlanded and flowered and bannered in this manner like a war hero returning from war. Madhu Kishwar, would you agree that every single moment of this footage is a slap in the face of that nun who everyone has forgotten and, like you rightly pointed out, belongs to the same congregation?
I stood in support of the church. Are you aware of it?
Not only that.
Do you read?
Remember, the church. The church fathers have clamped down on the nuns. They've been told to shut up. They've been threatened. To not at all open their mouths.
A fellow reporter was beaten up in Sabarimala.
We know that. On these poor, hapless nuns.
Did Madhu speak? Did Madhu speak on the beating of reporters?
Separate issue.
Sabarimala.
Separate issue. Separate issue. Why are you conflating the two issues here on India? We've reported both stories, sir.
You don't even know when I speak and when I don't.
Women is a common factor.
No. I'm sorry.
I don't read you. You don't read me. I'm telling you. I stood in solidarity with the nun. You don't want to believe that. It is your desire.
No, but you may be standing in solidarity with the nun, sir, but you're still saying that the church is not complicit in insulting the nun right now.
Because you haven't a clue of what is the church. The church is not complicit. His supporters in Jalandhar did this. Blame them.
Okay.
No more, no less.
Okay. You're playing both sides a little bit, John Dayal, but you're saying the church is not complicit. But these images
are
jarring.
You're being both aggressive and pompous on something.
I'm not pompous at all.
I can hear you.
I look at each story in isolation, sir. I look at each story in isolation. I'm not conflicting the two issues.
I have
spoken out. If you must know,
Madhu knows me.
Okay. To me, that's the big concern.
Madhu knows me for 40 years.
I'm out of time, but I'm going to wrap it up there. Thank you very much, Madhu Kishwar and John Dayal, for joining me on this discussion. The church definitely had a hand in making that hero's welcome for Francis Mulakkal. We'll keep an eye on that story and get more reactions coming in forward.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.